When the producers at Vertigo asked me if I wanted to direct the remake of Nicolas with the Ref, Pusher, at first, even though I was completely honored, obviously, for the offer, at first it felt I wasn't sure about it because Nicolas Pusher is just an amazing film. They wanted to make a new film, reinvented in London today, and we started working on the script.
I didn't see the original Pusher deliberately. I didn't think it was going to help me because we were making a very different movie.
I made the choice when I got offered the part not to watch it.
Do you know what? Lewis never actually told me. I heard it through the grapevine. It was like, I started talking, oh, have you seen it? And everyone's like, no, you can't pass it around. You're not supposed to be watching it.
And one of the things that I asked all the actors was, forget about Pusher, Nicolas Winding Refn Pusher. Don't even watch it. We're shooting a new film.
And didn't want us to just to recreate something that had already been created. He just wanted something original, something fresh, something new.
It's always strange seeing people that you have invented such a long time ago and spent so much time with being rethought. But I think Luis has done some interesting choices, and you know, it also needs to be adapted into the environment of the surroundings of England.
Frank and Flo, they live in a way in the margins of our society. He's a pusher, she's a strip dancer, and also a heroin addict. I wanted to show them also as normal guys, normal girls, normal people that have a normal life.
I play Frank, who is a kind of mid-level. He's not a big-time drug dealer. He's a nice guy who's sort of been, caught in this. He never wanted to spend his life being a drug dealer, but he sort of ended up in that. He never managed to get out and never managed to pursue his dream.
Working with Richard Coyle was just amazing. He's a great actor. You can see what's going on inside of his characters, you know. You can look at his eyes, his amazing blue eyes, and you can see what's going on in his mind, and he just brought so much to the character.
Now, Richard Coyle's Frank is certainly a fresh perspective on a character and giving him a different look than what I had, so important, so it becomes more of a re-envision.
I really liked the idea of taking an anti-hero and making him charming and likable as much as possible, because at the end of the day, this chap he's a criminal, and it's quite nice to play with that. You're just drawn on your whatever you've got in the basement. Do you know what I mean? Back down here, you just drawn it and put yourself in that place again and try and use it.
What are you looking at?
Take the trip that he does, that he takes in the film, and it's just incredible. So it was really an amazing experience.
What's wrong? What is it?
Nothing.
Who was that bloke you were talking to?
When I did the casting, I spot her. I didn't know who she was. I didn't know she was a top model. It was my first choice, and only later I find out she was a top model, and obviously, you know, look it up, and I thought, oh my God, you know, yes, she's very big.
Flo, who I play, I have two sides. One side of me is very vulnerable, quite childlike, a real dreamer. She's like this beacon of light, kind of feels like the situation that she's in, this is only temporary and that she's going to get out of it, but I don't know whether she will. And then there's this other side of her, which when she's at work, where she's this like vixen, she puts on her wig and her stripping outfits and she's like this totally different person. But then she's like quite secretive about her addiction, her heroin abuse, especially from Frank, and you know, she's kind of like spiraling out of control in quite a secretive way.
she had the perfect look for the film, very different from everyone else, all the other actors that I consider. And then on the set, she was just incredible.
I was very surprised seeing seeing her. I think that she is very vulnerable, which I thought really suits the character. I was actually quite surprised at how much I liked her automatically, just from seeing very little of her on screen.
She's a natural. I mean, it's quite astonishing, actually. She's she knows her way around a camera, clear, obviously. You know, she's amazing in front of a camera. And she really has a natural ease and a quality about her that just, you know, she was very, actually really relaxing to be around her.
Well, I wouldn't swallow it. What if it burst? I'd probably shove it on my ass.
You see, proof?
That's not proof.
A lady can't fit that much gag up her cunt.
Don't use that word.
Right, what am I supposed to say?
I don't know.
Pussy.
Pussy's fair. I like cats.
I love her accent, her personality. She will project such a piece in the set, and that was basically what we needed for her character, someone that who will compensate all the madness that goes around the character of Richard Coyle. Every time Agyness and Richard Coyle, they will be together in a scene, they will be really magic in the set. I mean, there will be something really special going on in every single scene.
Working with Richard, oh my God, it's so amazing. We've gone on a real roller coaster together, not only as Frank and Flo, but also as you work with someone and you get to know them, like the dynamic that you work together changes. As we do Flo and Frank, that relationship becomes really intense as well.
She was just really chilled out and relaxed. And yeah, I mean, I'm sure she was very nervous a lot of the time, but she never showed it. And it was like, it's really great now because, you know, I was just a bag of like, I was like a bag of nails. I mean, I was like jagged and like all over the place and ready to burst through the bag. And that's a terrible analogy.
Is that for me?
Open it. Sorry for last night.
You want me to try it on?
What it was very interesting in the relationship is that Frank has, especially during the week that the story that we tell in the film is a week of his life, it's a completely chaotic week, it's madness. And in that madness that goes in the life of Frank, we have the character of Flo that is the opposite. She is his anchor. She is peace. She is tranquility.
Frank is having a crazy week in his life, frantically trying to dig himself out of all the trouble that he's going through. Flo, my character, I'm in trouble in my own little way with my life as being a heroin addict. Also in this dance world, which I do as a job, tangled up in this love story with Frank where I'm so in love with him. But we just can't be together.
They can't quite consummate this relationship. It's like they don't know how. I think Frank, for me, one of the things was I think maybe Frank finds what Flo does for a living too difficult to deal with. I don't think he can quite compute and put that in his mind. I don't think, in a way, I didn't think he ever imagined ending up with somebody who was an escort / stripper / prostitute.
What time is it?
12. What happened?
God, the shit kicked out of me.
Goodbye.
Her apartment, the house where she lives, that's heaven for Frank. That's the place where he goes when he needs to be calm, when he needs to find a home, you know, when he needs to feel grounded. So that was what Flo will bring to his character. It will be the person who will compensate this madness. And one of the things that I tried to do in the film, one of the things that I tried to pursue from the very beginning, was actually explore the relationship between both characters.
Tony's a real fun character. He's a laugh. He's one of them guys you want to be around. One of them guys who kind of, you know, like if you're having a bad night, you want Tony around. He's gonna make things happen. He's gonna make the night. He's gonna make things different. He's gonna bring stuff that someone else ain't gonna bring.
Tony's this guy that goes with him because he gets free drugs, and obviously his character is so playful, he's so funny that anyone would want to spend time with him, and especially doing drugs with him. So that's what Frank finds interesting in Tony. He's like, is that assistant that he needs?
I imagined it like an older brother and a younger brother. And, you know, Tony is somebody that Frank feels responsible for and tries to help out. He's also a bit of a pain in the ass because he gets it wrong all the time. He puts his foot in it, he says the wrong thing.
Are you seriously asking what I think you're asking?
Yeah.
Tell you what, you show me yours.
Tony's got, I think, something in the back of his head that if something happens, he don't like it. And if he don't like it, that's it. He's not going to hold it back. He's just going to go for it. So he can flip at any moment, crack at any moment.
It's a friendship in a world where friendships don't exist. So when things get tough, when things get rough, you know, everything shatters. You know, it's also a business relationship at that point. Like, you know what, you screw me, or I think you screw me, so, you know, you're not my friend anymore.
I think there's a genuine love, you know. He cares about him and he wants to look after him, which is why what happens is so upsetting. You know, for Frank, it doesn't come easy, but it's like he's running out of options. He's running out of places to hide. Bronson's great. He's like a little whirlwind of energy, and, you know, he's funny, he's loud, he's, but he's delightful, you know, heart of gold, and, really great, and we had a lot of fun filming those scenes because he's really easy to improvise with. He's really easy to just, you know, he's chilled out, and it's great because it's like you can really fashion something and start creating something. He's up for it. He's brilliant.
The scenes that we're doing together, I'm just like cracking up. He like lifts my spirits, you know, when we're doing scenes together, and I think like everyone on the whole set.
No, that's that you are thief or liar.
Hakan, show him what they are doing with the people who steal money from us.
I play the character of Hakan, who's a Turkish immigrant. He basically comes to London to seek his fortune. He kind of gets caught up in this circle of violence and drug pushing with Milo, who owns a wedding shop as a front for his smuggling. And he's kind of a trapped character, really. He's not your stereotypical bad guy.
This is the second time I've worked with Mem, and he always beats me up. He's a big softy, really. He wouldn't like me saying that, but he's a big softy, even though he's a frightening man. He was great. He's really nice to work with Mem. He's very good, really sharp. You know, he really knows what he's doing. Very, very cool guy.
They've both got a mutual respect for each other. They said there's no honour amongst thieves, and that really applies for Milo and Hakan's relationship, but certainly not for Frank and Hakan. That they are almost like kind of buddies in a way, and they kind of look out for each other.
In the end, I had to go out there with a knife. It was bad.
What happened in the end?
He paid. He had the money all along. Only now he walks with a limp. I mean, how stupid is that, huh?
What is doing in the lake?
I put it there. I had to.
Kilo of dope in the lake.
I know. It's fucked. Oh, no, 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 no.
Think about those ducks, lucky ducks, or flying fishes, or something like that, huh?
He's a very big man, very powerful, intimidating in a nice way, you know, very, very curious, but obviously he brings all the crazy energy of the Balkans. I mean, you can tell, you can see it in his eyes. So it was always a surprise working with him.
I like to play that in that way, that even for me it's not absolutely clear who is the Miller.
Frankie, my friend.
Hey, 12 o'clock.
12 o'clock. Good.
Yeah, he was pretty crazy to work with, but in a good way. Actually, genuinely quite frightening, and so it was made those scenes really easy because I didn't really have to do a lot, because he would just start off and he was quite unpredictable. I didn't know what he was going to do from take to take. So he would just fly off on one, and I would literally just, no acting required. I'd be like, oh, Jesus. I'm glad there's a table between us.
You ripped me off.
I didn't.
It's not Amsterdam. You stole from me.
Luis has a very good, confident hand on everything. So, my God, it's his film. You know, it's Luis's movie.
This is my the biggest role that I've ever played in anything, and the way that he's been understanding, and you know, he seems to be getting, you know, stuff out of me that I didn't think was there.
He made me laugh. Actually, we would do a take, and he would say, "Oh, it's wonderful, beautiful, perfect. But can we do one more?" And I was thinking, well, if it's so great, why are we doing one more? But I kind of grew to know that this is how he works, and he's all about performance.
He's got a wonderful sensitivity about him, which actually makes him a fantastic director, fantastic actor's director. Well, he knows what he wants, but he allowed me constantly to play around, to try different things. He would find a wonderful way of getting exactly what he wanted, but making me think that I was getting exactly what I wanted, which is a real skill.
Even though it was very different to everything that I have done previously, it felt like, you know, working with great people, just really, really incredible. And I just had a great time. I felt really inspired working with such a amount of talent, English talent in the set. So it was just great. It was a great experience.
Frankie, you're my friend, but you're my man.
Well, this way you'll get the $3,000 quicker.
Okay.
Get the gear up, do the deal, come back with the money.
I don't have the dope, and I don't have the money.